This video is over consumer safety and drug regulations. Now let's look back to the 1800s. Miss Winslow's syrup quiets a crying baby. It contains morphine. Coca-Cola was rumored to use coca leaves, which is cocaine. Arsenic was used to treat syphilis, and then there were those patent products which offered questionable remedies. The traveling medicine show flourished during the 1800s with sales pitches peddling miracle cures and elixirs and tonics and other various products of questionable nature. Serious concerns were starting to be raised about these tonics and their safety, so in 1906, the Pure Food and Drug Act was put into law. False claims were banned, and drugs containing dangerous ingredients, such as morphine, needed a label indicating that ingredient. In addition, all drugs marketed in the United States had to meet minimal standards of strength, purity, and quality. Two references were officially established then with officially approved medications. These were the United States Pharmacopedia, the USP, and the National Formulary. The Food, Drug, and Cosmetic Act caused the formation of the FDA, the Food and Drug Administration. Medical devices and cosmetics are now under government control. This act mandated that all labels needed to contain active and inactive ingredients. This law required drugs to be pre-approved. The use of warning labels and caution labels were also outlined. This act was amended in 1951, and the amendment defined what substances needed a prescription. In 1972, the National Drug Code, or NDC, directory was established. You'll see this 11-digit NDC number when you look on the bottles, and it identifies the manufacturer, the drug, and the package size. The Controlled Substance Act was established in 1970. The DEA, or Drug Enforcement Agency, is now established, and tighter controls are put on drugs that were being abused by society. It gives a legal foundation to prevent drug abuse. As part of the Controlled Substance Act, abused and addictive drugs are put into 5 levels or schedules. DEA assigns which drugs are controlled and assigns a schedule which is based on abuse potential. The emblem that you see here in this slide shows the controlled substance number. It has a large C, and then it has the Roman numerals inside of it. Controlled Schedule 1 drugs have the highest potential for abuse, and they're not approved for medical use in the United States. These are drugs like heroin and LSD. The Controlled Substance 2, which is what you see here in this illustration, these are heavy-duty pain medications like morphine and oxycodone. Schedule 3 have moderate dependence like codeine and anabolic steroids. Schedule 4 drugs have lower abuse like diazepam, or you'd probably know that by brand name Valium, and Schedule 5 are even lower. With each controlled schedule, guidelines are given on how these medications can be ordered and how often. The Orphan Act of 1983 helps facilitate the development of drugs with rare diseases. In the past, pharmaceutical manufacturers have been really reluctant to develop medications for rare diseases because there's no money in it, there's no profit. This act gives tax credits, market exclusivity, and it waives fees for manufacturers. So again, here's our government agencies, which regulate and oversee the safe delivery of medications. The FDA oversees the safe development of drugs, and the DEA regulates the manufacture and distribution of narcotics, stimulants, depressants, hallucinogens, and anabolic steroids. Individuals who administer medications are under federal, state, and even their facility guidelines. As far as controlled medications are concerned, federal and state laws make it a crime for anyone to have a controlled substance without a prescription. Nurses may only possess controlled substances if they're giving them to a patient or if they themselves are the patient. Controlled substances must be in a locked box, and then the locked box must be kept in a locked cupboard. Records have to be kept for every dose of controlled substance that's administered in facilities. And in many facilities, the nurse will count the narcotics or those controlled substances at the onset of their shift and at the close of their shift, with the nurse taking over. Facilities also require two witnesses for a spill or wasting of a controlled substance. Well, that wraps up our first chapter on consumer safety and regulations. If you have any questions, bring them to class.